Hello everyone. Today we're taking a look at cards that trigger when minions are summoned, such as Knife Juggler and Starving Buzzard. Do they trigger instantly, or are they delayed? In this clip, we can see that if you play a Knife Juggler, a Starving Buzzard, and cast Unleash the Hounds, the Knife Juggler triggers instantly when each hound is summoned, then the Starving Buzzard triggers after the spell is complete. Interesting. Let's try a different setup. We'll play Dr. Boom with a Knife Juggler and Undertaker's out. A similar thing happens. The Knife Juggler triggers instantly for each Boom Bot, then the Undertaker's trigger after the battle cry is complete, triggering in order of play on each Boom Bot. Finally, one knife is thrown for Dr. Boom himself. And if you play Savannah High Main on this kind of board, we will see the Starving Buzzards and Undertaker's trigger together in auto play, then finally Knife Juggler triggers. Clearly Undertaker and Starving Buzzard are the same kind of trigger, and Knife Juggler is something entirely different. So what exactly is going on here? Let's review the entire sequence that occurs when you play a minion. Each of these phases must be resolved before we move to the next, and between phases, we handle deaths and update auras. In full, the sequence is the on-play phase, the battle cry phase, the secret activation phase, and the after summon phase. In particular, notice at the very top, the minion enters play and its summon event is created. But what about when you just summon, not play, a minion? Then the sequence is much simpler. The minion enters play and its summon event is created, then we resolve the after summon phase. The other phases don't exist because, of course, a summoned minion has no battle cry and is not played, and when a minion is summoned inside of a phase, we must resolve the sequence before we can continue. Simple enough so far, but this doesn't explain why when a beast is summoned, Knife Juggler triggers before Starving Buzzard. After all, we just said that the summon event is made first of all, so now we need to introduce the concept of instant and delayed events. Four kinds of events in Hearthstone are delayed events: damage, heal, summon, death. Delayed means that rather than being resolved as soon as they are created, they are placed in an event queue. Later, the event queue is emptied, and we resolve each event one by one in order of play. By the way, resolving an event means to queue and resolve all triggers on it. When we do an area of effect damage or heal, we create many events, and once every target is affected, we empty the respective event queue, resolving each event one by one. For example, when you cast Holy Nova, first you create all damage events, adding them to the damage event queue, then resolve all damage events in order of play. Then you create all heal events, adding them to the heal event queue, and resolve all heal events in order of play. This means that no minion can trigger on Holy Nova's damage before all of the damage has been dealt, nor can any minion trigger on Holy Nova's healing before all the damage and healing has been dealt. This becomes clearer when you look at Light Bomb. Light Bomb is currently bugged to resolve each damage event as soon as it is created. Therefore, if Light Bomb hits minions in order of play before Frothing Berserker, the triggers on each earlier damage event give him more attack than expected, allowing him to take more damage. Next, death events. In previous videos, we have proven that after each outermost phase, a number of steps run. Aura update health attack step, death creation step, aura update other step. For clarity, the death creation step is the new name for the death processing step. If multiple minions are at 0 health after an outermost phase, they don't have their death event resolved before the next minion dies. We create all the death events simultaneously in this step, then the next phase will be a death resolution phase that empties the death event queue. If Mal'Ganis and Abomination die simultaneously, regardless of order of play, Mal'Ganis' immune effect turns off in the aura update other step. Then in the subsequent death resolution phase, we empty the death event queue, resolving Abomination's death rattle and damaging your hero. Let's diagram what just happened. In the combat phase, Mal'Ganis and Abomination damaged each other, but weren't dead yet. After the combat phase resolves, we move to the death creation step. Both Mal'Ganis and Abomination are mortally wounded, so we create death events and remove them from play. Then we move to the aura update other step, and since Mal'Ganis is no longer in play, your hero stops being immune. Then since the death event queue is not empty, we proceed to a death resolution phase, resolving the Abomination's death rattle and damaging your hero. If death events were instant, either Mal'Ganis or Abomination's death would be resolved first, and the outcome would then depend on auto play. That leaves summon events. If they're delayed, when do they resolve? There is another step after each outermost phase that we did not talk about before, the summon resolution step, which is surrounded by aura update health attack steps. During the summon resolution step, we empty the summon event queue, which was filled with any summon events of the previous phase. We do this before the death creation step, so 0 or less health minions do not die until after the summon resolution step. Now it makes sense. Look at the playing a minion sequence once more. Because the summon resolution step runs after the on-play phase resolves, Starving Buzzard and Undertaker are triggering here. But in the summoning a minion sequence, because we are inside of a phase, the summon resolution step will run much later. This is why summoning a minion triggers after summon first, summon later. Now let's watch our various tests with Starving Buzzard, Knife Juggler, and Undertaker. Armed with your knowledge of the sequences, phases, and steps, you can now predict the outcome of these tests with certainty. Notice how the cleric remains alive until after the summon resolution step ends. Okay, now let's have some fun. If you summon 7 Starving Buzzards in the same phase, each Starving Buzzard triggers on the other 6 Starving Buzzard summon events, drawing 42 cards total. If the summon events were resolved instantly, you would only draw 21. This turn took 4 minutes in real time, by the way. In a previous Hearthstone Science video, we erroneously said that Garrison Commander and his brother Kaldara Drake triggered the Aura Update health attack step. In reality, alongside One-Eyed Sheet and more, they are summon triggers. To prove this, we'll play a One-Eyed Sheet, Garrison Commander, One-Eyed Sheet, and put Ancestral Spirit on each one. When they die simultaneously, we resolve death events one by one and resummon them in the same order they were played. Then, in the summon resolution step, One-Eyed Cheat 2 triggers on One-Eyed Cheat 1 summon event, Garrison Commander refreshes your hero power, and One-Eyed Cheat 1 triggers on One-Eyed Cheat 2 summon event. Here's what just happened. In the death resolution phase, each death event resolved its ancestral spirit and summoned the 3 minions in order of play, their summon events added to the event queue. Afterwards, we run the summoning resolution step, emptying the summon event queue in order of play. One-Eyed Cheat number 2 is in play to trigger on One-Eyed Cheat number 1, then Garrison Commander refreshes our hero power, then One-Eyed Cheat number 1 triggers on One-Eyed Cheat number 2. Summon events use the most up-to-date information. If the minion is stolen in the same phase it's summoned in, it will trigger for the new controller in the summon resolution step. Here, we play an Oasis Snapjaw with Ancestral Spirit on it, followed by Sylvanas. When the two minions engage in combat, they both die simultaneously. Due to auto play, a new Oasis Snapjaw is summoned and stolen in the same phase. Finally, the summon resolution step runs, and Starving Buzzard triggers for the new controller because Hearthstone does not remember previous game states. Now, let's look at the full list of summon triggers. Starving Buzzard, Undertaker, One-Eyed Cheat, Commanding Shout, Knight of the Wild, Garrison Commander, Kaldara Drake, Mallory X the Alchemist hero power. Some of these seem like unusual inclusions. Why are Garrison Commander, Kaldara Drake, and Commanding Shout summon triggers? Wouldn't it be more appropriate to code them as auras? As we'll see soon, the contradictory demands of these summon triggers lead to buggy behavior. For comparison, here is the full list of after summon triggers. Knife Juggler, Sword of Justice, Warsong Commander, and Ship's Cannon. You probably noticed that only Knife Juggler uses the word after. Unfortunately, the card text is misleading, and the other 3 cards are after summon triggers, not summon triggers. Finally, you might have thought about Cobalt Guardian and Murloc Tidecaller. These are actually triggers on the pre-summon event, triggering just before a summon event is created. These two minions have such unusual properties that they will get their own video in the future. But there is a problem with the summon resolution step. When a minion transforms itself, the post-transform state is technically not summoned. Yet, we expect self-transformers to work with Starving Buzzard by transforming into a beast, a commanding shout to remain on the post-transformed minion. The solution is the special summon resolution step. This replaces the summon resolution step that would follow the after summon phase. What's special about it? It empties the summon event queue and the transform event queue. This means that a minion transformed by a battle cry will be triggered on in this step. To demonstrate, let's play a Faceless Manipulator targeting a Savannah Highman. Nothing triggered on the Faceless Manipulator summon event, and the Savannah Highman transform event is resolved in the special summon resolution step after the after summon phase. That's why Knife Juggler triggers first this time. We can also demonstrate the specific timing by playing a Faceless Manipulator and having our Knife Juggler's mortally wound enemy explosive sheet. Because the special summon resolution step is before the death creation step following the after summon phase, the Starving Buzzard triggers before the explosive sheep death events are created or resolved. The problem with this mechanic, however, is that Battlecries that transform other minions, Recombobulator and Tinkmaster Overspark, also cause their target to participate in the special summon resolution step. Here's a demonstration. Tinkmaster Overspark transforms one Starving Buzzard into a Skrill. In the special summon resolution step, the other one triggers and draws a card. But that squirrel was not summoned, it was transformed. In general, minions transformed by spells do not run summon triggers, but minions transformed by battle cries do. This quirk, and the timing of when it happens, is useful to prove things are or are not summon triggers. Now, let's explore Commanding Shout. Knowing it's a summon trigger, what kinds of predictions would you make? Here's my list. Commanding Shout should not affect minions you steal, and should persist on minions stolen from you. Because it's applied by a trigger, not an aura, you should be able to silence it off. It should apply to played minions before the battle cry and summon minions after the current phase ends. It should apply to transformed minions after the after summon phase and never if they were transformed by a spell. First, let's watch steal, silence off, and stolen from. This behavior confirms our expectations of commanding shout being a summon trigger. Now, let's demonstrate that the target of Tinkmaster Overspark gains Commanding Shout post-transformation. The same is true for Recombobulator, but not for transformation spells. Notice when, and on what, the visual effect appears. Next, since we know that transformed minions do not gain Commanding Shout until the special summon resolution step, Snipe triggers earlier than that in the secret activation phase, and can mortally wound this faceless manipulator in its moment of weakness. And since summon events do not resolve mid-phase, if we play Commanding Shout, Grim Patron, and Bouncing Blade, the newly summoned Grim Patrons do not have Commanding Shout's effect, and may die to the Bouncing Blade. Finally, since the summon resolution step does run after each outermost phase, if we play Commanding Shout, then trade Grim Patron into Chillmore, the newly summoned Grim Patron gains the Commanding Shout effect before the subsequent death resolution phase where Chillmore's death rattle resolves. Next, Night of the Wild. Predicting that Night of the Wild is a summon trigger means that it should trigger on beasts created by transform effect battle cries, but not on beasts created by transform effect spells. Here, we test Recombobulator. Nine the Wild's cost reduces from 6 to 5. Here we test Drew the Saber. Nine the Wild's cost reduces from 5 to 4. Here we test Polymorph Ball. Nine the Wild's cost does not reduce. This confirms our theory. Next, Maloriac's Hero Power, the Alchemist. I'm going to let you exercise your brain now. Viewers, now you make the predictions.
Connect idea.
So, what is to be done about this? Personally, I think Commanding Shout, Garrison Commander, and Koldara Drake should be rewritten to work as auras. Then you can go back to the other 5 on-summon triggers and rewrite it so battle cries that transform other minions don't cause them to trigger. Or, you could just change them into after-summon triggers, which makes things nice and simple. As cool as this mechanic is, there's no way that all of these different cards can fit out in the same roof together, so I think that in the future of Hearthstone, the summon resolution step will become a relic of the past. Thank you for watching.